So we are here at the Optical Fiber Conference 2019 in San Diego in the Innolight private room. And with me, I have Osa Mok, CMO of Innolight. Osa, the industry is looking for 400 gig data center readiness. Can you tell us how ready 400 gig is for data centers?
Thank you. I'll be very happy to. So the 400 gig is very ready right now. As you can see on the show floor, there are many 400 gig part numbers being on display. And for Innolight, we have over about 20 part numbers of 400 gig already, and many of them are in productions. So what we are here, what we have demo here is a 400 gig QSFP-DD DR4. It's a 10 kilometer optics. We're using a CWDM grid. It's one of the more advanced 400 gig products that's available from us. Right? And over here, we have a Arista switch. It's a OSFP switch. And then we have a complete line of the 400 gig optics that's been operating on the switch. We have the SR8, we have the 2xFR4, we have the FR4, and we have the DR4. We also have the 100 gig PAM4 product, the DR1, FR1, and LR1. All of them are basically in operations.
Osa, could you touch a little bit on the differences in form factor? So you have OSFP, you have QDD. Could you highlight some advantages of those different form factors?
Certainly. So the OSFP is about one-third larger than DD. So by definition, it has a better power envelope. So power dissipation is better. The advantage of the DD is that because it's backward compatible to QSFP-20A. So it's a really a consideration for backward compatibility of the DD and also the power dissipation of the OSFP. Okay.
So also here you are showing your new silicon photonics 400 gig QSFP-DD DR4 module, and I see it runs over 2 kilometer fiber, not only 500 meters. Can you talk a little bit about the module and also about the measurements that you're doing here?
Okay, great. Yeah, thank you. I'll be happy to. So what we have here is a 400 gig QSFP-DD DR4. We have a couple of versions. The first version is EML based. The second version is SiPh based, silicon photonic based. So what we have on display here essentially is our EML based DR4 talking to our silicon photonic based DR4. And it's running over 2 kilometers. I guess technically it should be called TR4 plus, because the MSA is 500 meter DR4. But most of our customer requires two kilometer transmission. That's why we have a DR4 plus and transmitting over 2 kilometers. So we're measuring the TWQ, we're measuring the PAM4Is, and also the BER traffic. That's what we have. Yeah.
And then I see you have an impressive 1 dB TWQ measurement here.
Yes, it is a very very good performance indeed. I think the production spec is probably around 2 dB, around 2 dB or so. And then, but our design spec is slightly better than the production spec.
And this is your first silicon photonics module. So where do you see silicon photonics going?
That's a very good question. So silicon photonics, the holy grail of silicon photonics is that, the idea is a transceiver on a chip. So the silicon photonics today, nowadays, is mostly on the modulator side. It's only a piece of the component component technology. So going forward, I do see the there are more integration using silicon photonics, combining chip and the modulator together, and maybe later down the road even including the optic inside. Okay, thank you.
Thank you very much. Those are very impressive.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Thank you.